నమస్కారం. భగవద్గీత ఫోర్త్ చాప్టర్ జ్ఞానకర్మ సన్యాస యోగ ఫోర్త్ శ్లోక. సో ఇన్ దిస్ శ్లోక అర్జున్ ఇస్ ఆస్కింగ్ క్వశ్చన్ టు కృష్ణ. కృష్ణ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్డ్ దట్ దిస్ యోగ వాస్ టాట్ బై హిమ్ టు సన్ గాడ్ అండ్ ఇట్ వాస్ లేటర్ passed on to Manu, and from Manu it was passed on to the first king of Ikshvaku, that is Sun dynasty. So Arjuna has a doubt now. You were born, he is asking Krishna, you were born after Vishwasvan, so how am I to understand that you taught, you instructed this yoga to him, because it was told by Krishna in the first sloka. So he is asking that doubt in the third sloka. The period to which Arjuna and Krishna belonged was different from the period of Sun. So Arjuna has this doubt, how was it possible Krishna taught Sun? And he brought out that question in a very polite way, because when we are, this is a message we receive from this. We have to take for us as well as we have to tell the children also, because when we have a doubt, that should be delivered, that should be clarified, that in a very polite way. For example, in a class when a student is asking a doubt to teacher, there should be innocence. That is, sometimes they learn from some other sources and they test the teacher's knowledge. That also happens. Even at home nowadays, we find children learn from Google and test whether the parents, grandparents know about it. So you can find some mischievous smile on their face. So that should not be there. So this is a very important message to be taken from this sloka. Here, Arjuna are getting the doubt clarified, and he is asking the doubt in a very polite way. Why he had the doubt? The period to which Arjuna and Krishna belonged and the period of Sun was different periods. So he had that doubt, how come it was possible for Krishna to teach Vishwasvan? So he asked that doubt. So here the question is descension of God, and Arjuna inquires about it. And Arjuna had the doubt because Krishna belonged, he was a son of Devaki and Vasudeva. But Sun has been there since the beginning of creation. So how is it possible? Now, Bhagavan answers in the next sloka. So in fifth sloka we find the God answered, Arjuna, both you and I had many births. You have forgotten them while I remember them all, O Parantapa. Here Lord Krishna explains, because he is human, he should not be equated with other human beings. This is like when a jailer is in, he spends his time only, his working place is jail, and he is controlling, he is having, is dealing with the criminals in the jail. So it doesn't mean that jailer, because jailer is in the prison, so he is also, he has also done the mistake. He is there to take care of, to handle the people who have done mistakes. So when Bhagavan is in human form, it doesn't mean that he also has the same powers what we have. So that we are, our knowledge is limited, so we take it in that way. We believe in that way. So that is wrong. So we should understand that because God has come down to earth in many avatars, in many yugas, to control the bad things, to control the bad people. So there is a necessity for God to come down to earth and take care of the people and to protect the people from asuras and bad people. So here God descends to earth, but we are from material energy, but God has divine energy. So that this point we have to understand. So people who do not have belief in our scriptures, do not have belief in God, they say all that. Why God walks, talks, and he is leading a normal life, then how do you say that he is God? So they ask all these questions. In Rama Avatara, Rama behaved only as a normal person. He never displayed his divine power, because he wanted to show the people how to lead a life, a disciplined life. So that is why that avatar was taken by God. So people who have belief in God will understand all that. So how to know that we are different? The Jivatma is different from Paramatma. The super soul is all pervading. Bhagavan is all pervading. But Jivatma, it inhabits in a body. So we have only that body. That Atma has got only that body to live. Whereas Bhagavan is everywhere in the world. And when Bhagavan takes birth, we don't call it as birth, we call it avatar. Only we people are born, we say birth. And we are taking the birth because of our karma. Bhagavan is not taking the birth because of karma. He is taking that avatar to control the bad people, to remove all the evils from the world. So this is a major difference. And Bhagavan is a creator of laws of nature, and Jivatma is subject to laws. And super soul or Bhagavan, the upholder of all his creations, and Jivatma is upheld by him. And Bhagavan has he knows everything, and he has unlimited knowledge. Whereas Jivatma has no complete knowledge. And he has got divine power. He is very powerful. But Jivatma has not even have power to get relieved from Maya. So, differences between soul and supreme soul. So we cannot equate. Even Bhagavan comes in the human form, you cannot equate Bhagavan with others. So, just small story. When Arjuna and Krishna were going around the war field, that Kurukshetra war field, your sparrow comes to Krishna, and the sparrow asks for protection, and it surrendered to Lord Krishna. And Lord Krishna said, "No, whatever has to happen, it will happen, and I cannot stop that time wheel." Because the situation was, they were clearing all the trees. So there will be a chance for the sparrow to lose his nest where it has kept all his babies. So he is taking refuge in Bhagavan to save the babies. This was the situation. Arjuna could not understand the conversation between Krishna and the sparrow. Then Bhagavan asked Arjuna to give him bow and arrow. Arjuna was wondering why he has promised that he would not take any weapon during the war, but how come he is asking? But Bhagavan insisted on that, so Arjuna gave him bow and arrow, and Krishna aimed at an elephant, and a bell on elephant was dropped. And Krishna was aiming at only the bell, but Arjuna could not understand that, so he was making fun of Krishna. What is that? If you had asked me, I would have aimed at the elephant, I would have killed that elephant. But what, Krishna, you are doing? You didn't even aim properly at the elephant. But Krishna did not answer. So the bell was dropped and it was lying on the path. Then after the 18 days, they were coming back and they found the bell on the path, Then Krishna asked Arjuna to bring that bell. And Arjuna was thinking, why is asking me to collect that bell? But still he did it. Then from that bell, the mother bird came and he went around, he made one pradakshina around the Krishna, and it was like a thanksgiving. So the bird, mother bird, kept the babies inside that bell during these days. Now it is so happy that because it could save its babies. So that is why it was thanking God and went off. Now Arjuna could follow this, and Krishna explained this. Then Arjuna realized, because you are sitting just close to me in human form, I thought you are human. I didn't realize you are divine power. I didn't realize you are divine form. So he felt bad about it. So this is what happens. So when God comes to save people, devotees, to control adharma, he sometimes comes in a human form. And we have seen in the avatars, he took different avatars. How he came Narasimha avatar to protect Prahlada. That's the shortest avataram. In very short time he took that avataram and he protected Prahlada. He saved Prahlada, who was his great devotee, and he killed the demon king Hiranyakashipu. So this is what Bhagavan says. So this is the explanation we get it from this sloka. So Bhagavan says, oh subduer of enemies, Arjuna, you don't accept defeat before your doubt gets clarified. So when you have doubt, you better get it clarified and don't say that you are defeated with that. So use the knowledge what I imparted as a sword and slay doubt and have clarity in your mind. So this is what is. In sixth sloka, Bhagavan says, although I am unborn, the Lord of all living entities, and have an imperishable nature, but I appear in this world by virtue of yoga maya, my divine power. This sloka explains God manifests in different forms, in personal form and formless aspect. So for jnanis, they worship him in formless aspect because they realize that everywhere they can feel the God. But for us, people like us, we worship God in a particular form and we keep that form in our mind and we meditate on that. So God manifests in different forms as per the wish of devotees. He accepts that. So God is, we can say God is formless as well as God has got personal form also. And God is as divine energy. So that there are no material defects. Whereas the soul, Jivatma, is from material energy. Naturally, we have doubts. And this soul, what happens? When the body dies, it takes another body. That is, it takes another birth. So when a tiny soul has got this power to take another form, why can't God? We're all powerful. God can take any form. The people who follow divine path, they understand, they believe that God manifests in different forms. Even in scriptures, wherever in Vedic scriptures, it is mentioned that God does not have form, that implies that his form is not subject to the blemishes of material energy. It is in a divine form. Periyalvar, one of the Alvars, express this. Devudai meenamai aamayai enamai ariyai kuralai mooruvil ramanai kannanai karkiyai mudippan kovil sevalodu pedayannam செங்கமல மலரேடு உசலாடி பூவனை மேல் துதைந்தெழு செம்பொடியாடி விளையாடும் புனலரங்கமே. திஸ் இஸ் த பாசுரம். ஹீ சேஸ் வென் அவர் த ராட்சசஸ் த டெமன்ட் தி ட்ரபிள் தி குட் பீப்புள் எம்பெருமான் ஸ்ரீமன் நாராயணன் ஹீ டுக் அவதார்ஸ் லைக் மத்ஸ்ய அவதார கூர்ம அவதார வராக அவதார நரசிம்ம அவதார வாமன பரசுராம ஸ்ரீராம அவதார பலராமர் ஸ்ரீ கிருஷ்ணா கல்கி. ஸோ ஹீ சேஸ் பகவான் ப்ரொடெக்ட்ஸ் பீப்புள் ப்ரொடெக்ட்ஸ் ஆல் க்ரீச்சர்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் தி ஈவில் பை டேக்கிங் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் ஃபார்ம் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் அவதார் அண்ட் கம்ஸ் டவுன் டு எர்த் பூலோகம் அண்ட் ப்ரொடெக்ட்ஸ் all the creatures because everything belongs to him and he comes to them whenever a devotee is in trouble and he takes different forms. So all these avatars are well explained by Periyarvar in this pasuram. So he says yes, he takes different forms like how Prahlada was protected by from his father by God. He appeared as Narasimha, the shortest avatar. So if you take any avatar, you find God has taken that form to protect the people from demons, from evils, from bad people, and to establish goodness, establish dharma.